This problem deals with the hydrogenation of acetylene over a supportive Palladium catalyst in a packed bed reactor. And we need to start the process by actually evaluating the reaction kinetics, assuming a power rate law model given here, where we need to find K alpha and beta. And to do that, differential reactor data has been collected where at low conversion, the amount of A in the feed and B in the feed, or hydrogen in the feed, has been either varied or kept constant at a fixed temperature. And we've measured the outlet flow rate of ethylene, the product. And so the problem mentions that we can just do a quick estimate, and this is obviously made up data, so it's possible to do a pretty easy quick estimate. So, for example, we see that changing the partial pressure of A doesn't affect the rate of formation of ethylene at all within artificial noise here. So we can quadruple the amount of A and get no real change in the amount of ethylene, our product, being formed. And therefore, alpha, the order with respect to ethylene, is zero, right? Because A is evidently having no effect on the rate of reaction. Conversely, if we keep the amount of A fixed and vary, these are the three data points of interest, the amount of hydrogen, we see that doubling the amount of hydrogen doubles the rate in this case, and then tripling it from the original case also triples the rate. Right? And so therefore, we expect that the rate is going to obey first order behavior with respect to hydrogen. And then we want to do a quick estimate of K. And so remember that in the differential type reactor, that the rate, because of the low conversion, is equal to the outlet flow rate of the reactant. And so we can convert, for example, in a material balance, the change in the flow rate of ethylene with respect to catalyst mass. We can convert that to deltas because the conversion is so low, and so the partial pressures of each component don't really change with respect to distance down the reactor. Therefore, the flow rate of ethylene over the total catalyst mass that it sees is equal to the reaction rate constant times the partial pressure of hydrogen to the first power, because we've already determined that the partial pressure of acetylene doesn't matter. The K is what we want to solve for. Partial pressure of hydrogen, let's just take this data point, is equal to 4 atmospheres. The outlet flow rate of ethylene for that data point is equal to 0.0121 moles per minute. And the catalyst mass in the reactor is 25 grams. Okay, and then so we can solve for a value of K of 1.21 times 10 to the minus 4 in units of moles per minute gram catalyst per atmosphere. Okay, now we're going to use this information in part B in order to size the reactor, so we have our necessary kinetic expressions. And so we're no longer operating at differential conversion, and so we're going to have to actually integrate the performance of our packed bed reactor, of our tubular reactor. We'll need to use the fact that we can describe the amount of catalyst in terms of F naught, the integral of dx over the rate of consumption of A, evaluated from a conversion of 0 to a conversion of x, which is going to be 70%. And we will start to plug in some of our expressions here. So this is FA naught, integrate again from 0 to 0.70 dx. Okay, and now we have a expression in terms of the pressure. So we just have K, which we now have a value of, times the partial pressure of hydrogen. The remaining trick in solving the problem is just relating that partial pressure of hydrogen to conversion so that we can actually do this integration. Now, the amount of hydrogen that we have at any position in the reactor as a function of conversion, all right, is equal to the amount that we started with times 1 minus the conversion. Okay? The amount that we started with we can get from the ideal gas law because we're dealing with relatively low pressures here. All right, so the ideal gas law is a pretty good assumption. All right, so the flow rate of hydrogen is equal to the pressure times the volumetric flow rate over RT. And so what we can actually say is that the partial pressure of hydrogen is equal to the molar flow rate of hydrogen times RT over the volumetric flow rate down the reactor. So just an ideal gas law relationship. Okay, Okay, and so the flow rate of hydrogen in turn is equal to flow rate of hydrogen at the inlet. I'll call that FH2 naught times 1 minus the conversion. So here we start to see the conversion coming in. This defines how the molar flow rate changes with the length down the reactor times RT. Okay. Now the volumetric flow rate also changes down the length of the reactor, which is one of the complications of this problem. Right, and what we can see is that the flow rate, as you go to 100% conversion, gets cut. The volumetric flow rate will get cut in half, right, because the total number of moles is going to decrease, going from 2 to 1, as a result of this reaction. And since we're feeding only the pure components at equal molar ratios, okay, and so we'll have a decrease in going from 0 to 100% conversion of the volumetric flow rate to half its original value. And that functional dependence is described by the initial volumetric flow rate times 1 minus 0.5 times x. Okay, and this value, this negative 0.5, if you're using Fogler, is equal to what he calls YA naught times delta, where YA naught is half because half the feed is composed of hydrogen, and delta is negative 1 because for each mole of hydrogen that reacts, we lose a mole of total gas. Okay, so this is what we can now substitute in for our partial pressure of hydrogen, okay, in terms of conversion. So I'll just point out that we're using this expression. All right, but we're going to now start plugging in that pressure of hydrogen. That's going to complicate things a little bit. And when we can collect the constant terms on the outside of the integral. So we have a FA naught divided by a KRT, and we have a volumetric flow rate up here and an initial flow of hydrogen here. And what I'll point out is that the initial flow rate of A is one of our reactants, hydrogen is the other. Those are the same because we're using an equimolar mixture in the reactant, so those two cancel because FA naught is equal to FH2 naught. And we have our integral, which is from 0 to 0.70 dx 1 minus 0.5x minus x. Okay, and now we can start plugging in for some of the values that we know here. And I won't go through and do all of this solution. This is a value that can be determined through the back of a textbook, integrating calculator. The volumetric flow rate is given as being 1,000 liters per minute. Right, K, we determined earlier in the problem, is equal to 1.21 times 10 to the minus 4. The gas constant that is probably most convenient to use is 0.082 atmospheres, liters per. And then finally, the temperature is 400 Kelvin. And I at least get this, the value of this quantity integrated to be equal to 0.952. And so this all leads to a catalyst mass about 240 kilograms. This problem illustrates how we can start with the kinetic data that we determined from the first part of the problem, that it was a first order dependence on hydrogen, zero order dependence on acetylene, and we know the value of the rate constant, and use it to solve for the catalyst mass needed in a packed bed reactor.